Coach, man, what a huge win for your ball club here tonight, beating a very, very good Co-Lin team to push your record to 4-4 in South Division. That's just simply, I don't know how to say it any other way, it's just simply amazing that we got this win here tonight. Missing as many free throws as we did.
Man, I'm going to try not to get emotional. Try not to get emotional. When I was hired, I was asked to Dr. Lewis, Dr. Brillwood, and the committee that hired me, they asked me if I'd build a great program, not a great team, but a great program. And man, in 5 years, I don't deserve any of this credit. Ah, woo. You gotta thank the good Lord above, but you gotta thank those assistant coaches, those girls for buying in every day, doing everything I asked them. I don't coach them soft for these moments. And I thought, you know, last week, man, everybody counted us out. Everybody thought we were out, Kerry.
Yep.
And I told those girls on Friday, I looked at them. Man, girls mean a lot to me. I told them they were champions. And I said, I'm going to tell you what. Some people have a tough week. Some people have tough lives. We just had one tough week. We're going to bounce back. And those girls said they were. Ja'Kia Harper, man, I'm so happy for her to see that ball go in. Only 4 points, but four big ones. Libby Mosley, same thing. Made that big three late. That's a girl that was a starter when we played Co-Lin the last time. Uncharacteristic for us from the free throw line. However, I think the girls were probably a little bit excited and amped up. And, you know, we showed a motivational film before today. And this is what it was about, man. So, Mike Tyson, everybody he's ever knocked out has never got back up.
Wow.
Ever. So Buster Douglas, he gets knocked out. He gets up right there at the bell. And 2 days before that, Buster Douglas's mom died. Mm. But his mama told him, you'll beat Mike Tyson to be the heavyweight champion of the world. I showed that video to these girls twice because the moral of the story was when he got knocked down, he didn't quit. He didn't die in that moment. He rose up and he rose to the occasion. And tonight we knew Co-Lin's back was against the wall the same way as ours was. Co-Lin's got a talented ball club. We got a lot of respect for them. However, that's the same team that ended our season last year. And we hadn't forgot that, 69-66. You remember that.
One that rimmed out.
These girls have bought in. I think we needed last week, in a sense, to get closer as a ball club. For Shania Wright to get three fouls early in the first half. You know, for other girls to step up, I thought Libby Mosley was spectacular.
Nine boards.
God dog it. I thought Alana Smith, that's three straight 20-plus games.
Right.
I know you want to ask some questions, and I'm sorry for rambling.
No,
but, man, this means a lot to me because I know Co-Lin has been the standard, Kerry. Co-Lin has been the standard. And that's a good ball club. And tonight was a total team win. You know, I got on the pool and Alana there late, and I said, listen, who you can't go to the free throw line and miss three free throws right then. I love you to death, but listen, if we are trying to win a championship,
yeah,
we've got to go up there. And I told them, you are champions. And just a gutsy performance from everybody around. I just thought Alana Smith, I thought our man-to-man defense was phenomenal. What'd they have, 42? What'd they have?
65-51.
All right, so to give up 51 points on our home court to a team that, to a coach that's got 900-plus wins, that's a, man, all those girls deserve the credit. So I'm very thankful to the administration for, anyways, go ahead.
No, you're good. Take your breath. Let's talk about a couple things. Shania got in foul trouble. She never quit battling. You know, she kept battling when she's in there. She goes to the line. She's perfect 6-for-6 at the line. That was huge tonight. But, you know, you go back to the play of Alana Smith. Smith, she did it everywhere tonight. She slashed in there. She hit the short jumper. She hit one behind the arc. She had a couple assists. Her maturity as a basketball player these last four games, Scotty, has probably been the thing that I think has brought this team to another level.
Yep.
You're still getting good play down in the paint from Libby Mosley, said nine rebounds. But, you know, I look at what Alana Smith has done the last four games. It takes this team to another level.
It does.
It really does.
It does. And like you're saying, I mean, when you can rely on your sophomores and you can get production from them the way we've gotten production from Alana and Pooh and Shania and Libby.
Yeah, yeah.
Even though, like I said, now listen now, Ja'Kia gives us 4 points tonight and Malia gives us three. That's 7 points, right? So it was 60 what?
65-51.
All right, so you take away those seven, it's 58-51.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Oh, yeah.
The thing that I never say this to, if I'm chasing perfection, okay, hear me out. Pooh misses those three free throws, okay? Then next possession down, they score. Then Pooh gets that foul call. We had empty possession after empty possession after empty possession. If we're going to be a championship team, we cannot shoot ourselves in the foot like that. We have got to make veteran plays down the stretch. And, you know, like I said, missing those free throws, we shoot 100 a day. And here's what happens. When you go to the free throw line and you miss a few, it becomes a little bit contagious, and tonight that's what you saw. However, we've got to have a clear mindset, and that ball's in those guards' hands. They've got to go up there and make those shots.
Well, you know, look at Alana tonight. You know,
she's playing a lot of minutes, too.
And she did. And I said to Marcus, she's tired right now.
Yeah.
I've seen her play enough following high school and watching her up here at the Pearl River for 2 years. She looked tired. And I noticed that normally when she shoots her free throw, she'll lean forward and follow through. And when she didn't do that, and you can go back and watch film.
Right.
She didn't get that fall through and didn't go in for her. Five out of six she missed. I noticed that. I want to go back to something. I want to go back to the play again of Libby Mosley. Shania's in foul trouble. She's got to sit the bench a lot tonight. Libby Mosley, man, what a great job of that sophomore from Pearl, Mississippi. I mean, her nine rebounds were critical in this win here tonight. Throw everything aside.
No doubt.
Those nine rebounds, without them, eight on the defensive end, we're in trouble.
Here's the other part about that, too, man. And you know this, being a basketball junkie. You saw a few games ago with her being at that four, man. And I'm going to tell you what, we started putting her with the post, and she was a little stubborn with that. And I said, hey, your goal is to be on the floor. It's not don't worry about a number. Worry about being on the floor. And so for her to really buy in these last few weeks, man, I can't brag enough on her. And I'm going to tell these girls afterwards, like I said, I got on the Pooh and Alana right then. Pooh's got to make that wide open three, and she's got to make one, if not two or three of those free throws. And here's the thing. She's an 85% free. And here's the thing. You've got to be mentally tough when you miss that shot to go up there and say, I got the next one, and fix your face. Libby missed it. You know, we just kind of hit a stretch, man. And I'm going to be honest. I think we were so excited of playing because of that motivation that we knew that this was a must win. Hey, it's one game at a time.
Yes, that's right.
It's a great week to go 2-0 after going 0-2 last week. You got to think about this, Kerry. Tough times don't laugh, but tough people do.
Exactly.
And I'm going to tell you what, to go 0-2 last week with the way we lost, you know, you'd rather lose by 10 or so. Think about it. You lose two games by a combined of 3 points. Man, that's tough. And those girls deserve all the credit. Very thankful for my staff. And let me say this too, man. Go ahead and ask another one, but don't let me forget to brag on Coach Smith with that surprise.
Go ahead.
Well, Coach Seth Smith, man, and Coach Avalon and Coach Meeks. I mean, look at the attendance. Look at the Andy Gilstrap and the band. There's so many people. You know, football has study hall Tuesday, Thursday night. They get right there in that section. They're right there behind the bench.
Yeah.
And they cheer the whole game. And if you don't think that didn't have a six-man advantage and helped us win, as well as that band, that baseball and softball team being on that baseline carry, I don't know what else to say. And look, we get the credit, but guess what? Pearl River won tonight. From an institution standpoint, from a program standpoint, and we're still growing. We got to, hey, I think this, and that's what I told the girls a few weeks ago, we aren't playing our best basketball, but we're going to get there. Maybe this is going to be the turning point, and let's hope so, that we're really trying to really dig in, and I shortened our rotation a little bit tonight. But, heck, you got to go with those girls. I thought Alana Turner gave us great minutes, but everybody contributed tonight, but I cannot thank Coach Smith, Coach Avalon, Coach Meeks, and all the coaches for having those student athletes here. Look at this environment. This is second to none.
It is. Coach, one more thing. 7-15 behind the arc.
Yeah,
47% shooting three-pointers tonight. That's huge. You know, as many free throws as we made, as many as we missed, you make up some of that when you get it behind the arc. Yeah. And that was huge.
Yeah, and who would have thought, you know what you said last year? Remember when we beat this team here last year? Gabby made that three, and you said, you kept talking about it. I'll never forget. You just kept on like, man, we won by three, and you kept saying, Scotty, or Coach Fletcher, right? Libby! Golly, I love that girl.
We're going to get Libby on here. We're going to get her for about a minute or two. So,
listen, I love you, man, more than you know. Looked at me. You mean a lot to me. These viewers out here that listen to Kerry, listen to Mark, you guys mean a lot. I don't know every one of you, but I know one thing. You mean a lot to our girls. You mean a lot to our program. I'm very thankful for you. Thankful for these kids. I'm thankful for their families. I'm thankful for the administration. Thank God above. What a great win. Great night to be a Wildcat. Go Wildcats. Praise the Lord. Go Wildcats.
Libby Mosley, the sophomore from Pearl. Libby, nine rebounds for you tonight. those rebounds were key because Shania gets in foul trouble, and her getting in foul trouble, you got to kind of go in there and take over on the glass.
Yes, sir.
Let's talk about that.
When somebody's down, I got to step up and, you know, pick up where they left off.
Libby, y'all went through a tough stretch there. You lose two games in a row on last second shots we had. We didn't get to go down, okay? And then we come back, we get a big win over Meridian, and we come here tonight playing a team that, let's face it, we had them down 8 points at the half last time over there. I was worried about the third quarter. You know, we're up in this game. Y'all came out and y'all took control in that third quarter. Coach told us about the Mike Tyson and Buster Douglas video, and he said he thinks it made a little bit of difference in y'all's psyche tonight.
Yes, sir. He give us motivational speeches and videos, and that really helps out get the team going. And when he rah-rah, we rah-rah back.
Let's talk about your teammate, Alana Smith. Three games in a row with 20 points or more for her.
Yes, sir. I'm very proud of her. She's been doing great the whole season, and I expect that the rest of the year.
Libby, great job tonight. Great win for the Wildcats. You were a major part of that tonight. You know, you not a lot of points. In fact, I think 5 points. Let's see, where'd you end up? 8 points, counting the three-pointer. 8 points and 10 boards.
Yes,
I had you for 10. They got you for 9. We'll go with my 10.
Yes, sir.
How's that?
Yes, sir.
Libby Mosley, great job. Sophomore right there from Pearl, Mississippi.